Besides the motion tween, there are two other tweens in Flash that you should be aware of, the shape tween and the classic tween. Now, if you're looking through CS4 information or below, classic tweens are what we used to call motion tweens. So it's kind of confusing because our new motion tween for CS5, CS6, and Flash CC, Creative Cloud, those ones are the new motion tween. And if it's CS4 and below, that is what we now consider a classic tween. So I'm going to show you both of these tweens. And we'll first start with a classic tween, which is very similar to a motion tween, except for it tends to be a little bit harder because you have to really set two keyframes and then add a motion tween in between, and it just gets kind of tedious. But it does have some great stuff in terms of using a guide layer. So let's say this rocket, I want to have it kind of loop a couple of times and then crash. That's what I can do with a classic tween. So for this rocket layer, for the first keyframe, I will drag my rocket out, my rocket movie clip, and I should just change to the move tool real quick. And now, let's say 100 frames in, I want to have it animate and have it be over here. So I'll add a new keyframe. So I'll hit F6 on my keyboard. And that new keyframe, what it does is it copies the keyframe that was directly to the left of it. Even though it's all the way over here, it was the last keyframe to the left of it. So it copied whatever was on that keyframe. And now I can move my rocket over here. And let's go ahead and change this to 100% so we can see this. And I want to transform it so that it's going to start crashing. Now, as you can see, for the first 99 frames, it stays in this one spot. And then all of a sudden it's over here. So we need to tell Flash that it needs to create a classic tween in between these two keyframes. So clicking on any frame in between, I'll right click and do create classic tween. And it turns purple, and this line lets us know it's going to animate from point A to point B. So now as we move it, you can see that slowly does it move across and it rotates. And the problem with that is that I actually want to have it go in this direction and come back down, and it's just animating in one straight line. And as you can see with a classic tween, we don't get that motion path, so I can't curve it and I can't change it because it doesn't have one. So we can do something called a guide. I'll go ahead and create a new layer, and I'll call this guide for the rocket. And I need to double click that layer icon so I can change this to a guide layer. Now I need to tell it that the rocket should follow this guide. And I can do that by dragging it underneath the guide layer. Even though it's already underneath it, you can see it kind of indents. So I want it to indent, and if it does it correctly, it's going to be indented underneath the name for that guide. And then the guide layer all of a sudden has this kind of snake-like motion path thing happening. So now we have that rocket and it still has its motion tween, but we need to build the guide on the guide layer. So I'll grab the pencil tool, and I would be leery of using the brush tool because it can sometimes create gaps inside of it and then it'll mess up your animation. So ignoring the rocket for now, I'm just going to go ahead and draw my path, and this is going to be invisible when it actually plays in the animation. Okay, so I want it to loop a couple of times and then come crashing down. Now what I need to do is with my move tool, I'll click on the first frame of my rocket layer, and as I move it around, there's this central point right here, and I need that to snap to the very beginning of my guide, well, my guide. And now I can go to the very last frame and grab that last keyframe. Same thing, I need that central point to snap to the end of it. And I can go ahead and use the transform tool to kind of rotate it so that it tries to follow the same path. So let's see what's happening. So it is in fact following my guide, which is fantastic, but it's not natural motion. It should go up and turn around and come back down. And that's where we can click inside this classic tween and choose orient to path, and now it should orient. So let's check this out, and that looks really good. So let's go ahead and watch this. And that's the benefit of using a classic tween. So the other type of tween is called a shape tween. I'll go ahead and lock these layers so I don't mess them up, and I'll create a brand new layer called shape tween. And I'll do a demo for this layer and then actually do something with text so we can transform text from a blob of color to an actual letter. So for this one, a shape tween means what it says. It's only for shapes. So you can't take a bitmap image, you can't take a movie clip symbol and transform them. So for this shape tween, I'm going to go ahead and just make a circle. And that's the first keyframe. And then this last one, I don't want to hit F6 because that's going to copy that original keyframe, and I want to morph it or transform it into a whole different shape. So instead, I'm going to add a blank keyframe. So I'll right click and do insert blank keyframe. And on this keyframe, let's say I want to do a star. So I'll change it to star. And I'll even change the color and we'll see what happens with that. So I'll draw this star out. And now we have the second keyframe and the first keyframe. And in between, I can right click and do shape tween. So now it's going to morph that green circle to the pink star while also changing the color. So you could definitely do that with a shape. Now, a cool trick for this is to transform words from different shapes. So let's say I wanted to have the word fly or go, something. I can, on the first keyframe, let's go ahead and delete that shape tween layer. On the first keyframe, I want to add a letter, or actually let's just do a shape. So maybe we want this one to be red, and so we want to have red, and from here I want it to morph into the word, or the letter F, and then the next one I'll have L, and the next one I'll have fly. But now I need to create a shape here in the shape of an F. So I can do a blank keyframe, F7 on my keyboard. And I could draw an F with my brush, but I'm going to just go ahead and use the text tool. The text is not actually a shape, but we can make it a shape. So we'll just do, let's do hobo. So I'll type the capital F. And I can make it a little bit bigger. So right now that's not a shape, so the shape tween won't work. So if I right click in here and do shape tween, you can see that it's a broken line because that's not going to work. So instead, I need to break this text up. So I'll go to modify and break apart, and that's going to turn it into a shape. So it's no longer editable. You can't double click in there and erase it and type a new letter. Now I can right click in here and do create shape tween. So it's going to morph from that circle to an F. So then I can do the next one with, let's say, a yellow and then maybe a green, and it's going to have the word fly. Hopefully that gives you an idea of your other options when it comes to tweens. The Motion Tween in CS5, CS6, and Flash Creative Cloud is a lot easier and you have a lot more options, but don't forget about these because these can come in really handy, especially the classic tween with a guide layer.